What's your address?
Hey, don't tell me you don't know what your address is.
I don't know any of you. You might do something bad to my parents.
How dare you?
All we want here is to get our means of livelihood back. Where is your conscience?
What you're doing to me feels like illegal detention. I can sue all of you.
Madam Galletta, don't we have 5 more days?
I know. 2,000 bucks. You better get it ready.
That's board and lodging. Actually, that's added to your debt to us. 2 bucks a day.
Expensive. Lend me money.
What?
If you help my son, you will get suspended.
He's probably really cold right now. He might get sick.
Where's the nearest ATM? I'll withdraw some money.
Okay. Hey, how dare you! You're dead once I catch you!
Bullseye!
If you know of another way to pay us, you should say it now.
I don't.
Tie him up so he won't escape next time.
Dad, what about the necklace from Mom?
Madam Galletta, who are these people?
Foreign buyers for my land.
Madam Galletta, we still have 3 days.
Counting this one, that's 2 days left.
You're making me laugh. Why can't you accept the fact that I have no money to pay you?
I know that you have money, Xander. What you don't have is a conscience.
Why is he here? What's he doing here?
He's the new consultant for the hotel. For further details, ask your husband.
I saw how much Mom's pleased with him. She must have other plans for him. I have a feeling it's something else. I won't let that happen. I need to find Xander.
We can have an art fair or concerts. We can hire local or foreign bands. The main objective is to attract the younger crowd. The younger generation, a new demographic.
And to coincide with this, we are going to develop an active presence online to engage our target market. We are going to tell the story of the Grande Hotel Group on social media. That it's great to be grande.
Good job.
Thank you.
We're very excited. Thanks. Good job.
Hi, boy. Here, have some breakfast.
I ate already. Thanks a lot. Have you seen Agnes?
Oh, she left quite early. She said that she'll go to town first. Didn't she tell you?
Did she say why?
You know how that girl is. Maybe she wants to find a way to earn some extra money to pay Madame Galletta.
Excuse me.
All right, I'll just leave this inside. You can just eat this later.
I have to go.
Oh, where are you going? You'll go after Agnes?
I won't. I need to meet with someone.
Oh, take care, boy.
You're so slow. I'll do it. Give it to me. I really can't believe this.
We could pull everything off.
With your support and with the help of Julius, I really think we can pull this off.
Meg.
Yes.
Meg, tell me what's happening.
I am so impressed.
That Julius is really one of a kind. Do you know that his proposal together with Sir Alex was approved right away? Impressive!
I took up digital brand management.
How about your cousin?
Oh, $100. That's the most I can give.
$100? That's way too low. Can't you just give it to me at $500?
Are you crazy? Even if I buy this, it won't be for more than 300.
$300 then.
You should be thankful I'm giving you 100 for it, miss. This necklace doesn't have value anymore.
That necklace is worth more than that, miss.
Then pawn it elsewhere.
Miss, wait.
What?
Okay. But promise me you won't sell it, okay? I'll come back for it.
Okay.
Promise?
All right.
You won't give it to someone else?
Are you pawning it or not?
All right.
Okay. Buy it back.
Here's your food. That's a dollar.
Dude, where are you? Our sponsor for the base jumping event won't talk to us. You're the one he made the deal with, and he's threatening to sue. Get back. We need you here, man.
Oh.
Miss, how many times do I have to tell you? I'm Bettina Rosales, Alexander Grande III's mother. All I'm asking for is an update on his bank transactions.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but it's the bank's policy that such information shall only be disclosed to the account holder.
But I am telling you, I am his mother. What else do you need to know for security purposes? Date of birth? Address? How many pounds he was when he was born?
I'm really sorry, ma'am, but it's against bank policy.
Ouch.
Hey, go back.
Where's Agnes, please?
She's not around.
What about Dad?
Hey, who says you can call him Dad?
I mean, Agnes's father.
He's not around either.
I really need to leave.
Why? Do you have the money to pay us?
I don't, but I really need to leave.
No pay, you stay. Period.
You were still so small when I last saw you. But I can see you're still as handsome, you know. Handsome. Look at you. You are, so big.
Oh, what do you expect, Meg? I've got handsome genes. I'm just kidding.
Oh, you're hurting me.
Oh, sorry.
You're always full of yourself.
Julius.
You're so conceited.
Oh, Bettina.
Congratulations. It seems like you impressed everyone with your performance earlier. Especially Mom. You certainly take after the Grandes.
Thank you, Bettina.
By the way, I've been meaning to ask you. Which side of the Grandes are you from?
No, I'm not a Grande. I'm the younger brother of Sherry. Excuse me, I just gotta pick this up. Hello? Oh, bro.
Sherry? As in...
Yes! The legal wife of Sir Alex. I mean, the ex-wife. Excuse me.
I heard you called the bank. They said you were asking about the transactions of Sander. Why?
I'm just looking for Sander.
Didn't I tell you that we won't look for him anymore?
But what you didn't tell me is about that guy, Julius. Is the younger brother of your ex-wife?
That's exactly my point. That's the reason why I didn't want to tell you. Because I know that you're going to overreact. And I know you're going to make a big deal out of it.
It is a big deal. It matters to me. I am worried that Sander might not get what rightfully belongs to him.
Can you stop being paranoid? What are you so afraid of, Bettina? Am I not the president of the company? As long as I'm here, Both of you will never lose your place in this family.
Agnes,
Aunt Mirasol,
where did you go? Your father has been looking for you.
Oh, I just went to town to sell my stuff. I got around 100 bucks. Have you seen my dad?
Oh, he said he's meeting with someone. He left a while ago.
Okay.
Agnes! Agnes!
Hey, where are
you? Hey, Agnes!
What now?
I need to go back to Manila. I need to attend my business.
Manila? I thought you were from Cebu.
My business is based in Manila.
So now you have a business.
If I don't fix this now, then I will lose a lot of money.
What about the harvest you destroyed? We also lost it, right?
I will pay you back. I'll just fix this problem first.
How did you know about the problem?
I got a text from my friend.
A text? You said you lost your phone.
What's that?
You still have your phone? You didn't lose it? You're really such a big liar. You know, you call everyone you can reach right now. Your parents, your friends, everyone.
It's broken.
Now it's broken?
Give me that.
Here, why don't you put your SIM card there? I'm sure you have numbers saved in there, right?
Is this micro SIM?
It's not.
It's not working.
Can we still sell this?
10 bucks tops.
Please listen to me. I really need to go. Once I'm done, I promise I will come back. And I'll pay for all of it.
Why don't you try being a writer? You're brilliant at making up stories.
I'm telling you the truth.
Don't take us for fools. You have one day to tell us the truth. The whole truth. You have one day left to make it up to us.
Boy? Hey, boy, have some porridge. Oh, Agnes, will you kindly get this porridge here? Boy, it's getting late. You'll be leaving early for the mineshaft tomorrow, right?
This needs to look good for Oka tomorrow.
You mean that... Boy, you're going to sell this?
I should have done this a long time ago.
How do we go about delivering our produce and other harvests?
If I have to carry all of our harvest every day to sell them downtown, then I'll do it. To keep us from losing La Presa. I should have done this long ago. Then none of this would have happened. You wouldn't be forced to sell your possessions. And Agnes wouldn't have pawned the only possession that's very valuable to her.
But Dad, that's also important to you, right? You saved up for so long just to buy that.
Well, we can't all live in this truck, you know. We just won't fit. We can't plant here either. Once we sell this truck, we'll be able to pay Madame Galletta. And we'll have some cash left. We will get back all the important things that you were forced to sell. You can also reclaim your necklace. still have some left. So what do you want? You want to have your hair rebonded?
No need, Dad.
I'm sorry, Alex. Whatever decision you have made regarding our son, I know that you're right. I should have just listened.
Thank you. Go and change. I'll wait for you downstairs.
Alex, I love you.
I love you too.
What's this? Alex, Julius, why is everyone here? Oh, what is going on? Huh?
Odd. I heard you liked waltz.
Why, yes.
Oh, that's why I arranged this party for you, and for the officers of this hotel, to give you guys a chance to relax.
Oh.
Mom, when Julius told me about this plan, I knew it was a good idea, since I know how you love dancing.
Thank you, son. Thank you. Thank you, Julius.
Shall we dance?
Sure. Dennis, please.
Cesar!
Coming, coming!
We're going to be late! Banky. Banky.
Hmm.
Make sure that he doesn't escape.
Okay.
Always stay alert, Banky, okay? You guard him well, so don't sleep too tight.
What? You mean you don't want me to sleep the whole night? Hey, you're asking for too much, you know.
Don't worry, Banky. The minute we get work at the mineshaft, we'll pay for your efforts.
Yes.
Where's the key?
Safe and sound.
Okay, let's go.
This might be late.
Let's go.
Come on.
Okay.
Wonderful surprise, Julius.
Aunt, this isn't a surprise yet.
Oh,
this is oh so lovely.
Because the real surprise
Madame
is coming.
Grande will be so delighted to see you. Come on, come on. We're having a party. We are having a blast. Julius.
Mr. Montecilio, how are you?
Julius, I'm good. How are you? I'm good.
Hi. Hello. Hi.
Oh, Alex, you're here.
It's nice to see you here.
You know each other?
Yes, he's one of our guest speakers back in Cornell. And ever since then, he became my mentor. I'm glad I convinced him to come over.
Wow, thank you. Thank you.
We shared some laughs at Cornell. Yes, we did. Some insights on the economic status of the Philippines, right? Well, Soledad, you have a bright boy here.
Thank you. Oh.
I didn't know that Julius was your brother-in-law, Alex.
Well, yes, he is.
Oh, shall we dance?
Aren't we going to feed them first? Okay, then later.
Sorry.
I almost forgot.
Please, please be seated.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're such a... Huh?
Oh. What was that?
What was that? What? What? Oh, goodness!
What happened?
It was an accident.
Get out of here! Get out of here! You get out of here! Get out of here!
Hey,
are you driving to town?
We'll pass there, but we're headed to Divisoria in Manila.
Can I hitch a ride?
All the way to Divisoria? There's no space. At the back. You ride at the back. Be careful with the vegetables, okay? Hey, are you coming? We're in a hurry, let's go.
My dear, do you still remember when you were still a child? Every time you threw a tantrum, this is where your mother Rosario and I would always find you. Your mother would carry you in her back while she's busy planting in the fields the whole day. That took all your tantrums away. Actually, you first learned how to plant there in the fields, then to write your name. This place is in fact filled with so many beautiful memories. Like Mirasol, she won the crown during the town's feast day. She was so beautiful. And Cesar, he used to win all those declamation contests. And that Banky, you know, you won't believe this, but he used to be the most striking man in the whole town. The women would swoon over him. That is why La Presa is so special to all of us. This is the place where we've grown and flourished and became one. All my life I thought, this is where I'll be laid to rest. That's why all of us dearly love La Presa. It's true that it's easy to leave and then start anew someplace else. But then, it's not simply our homes and our livelihood that we will be leaving behind here. Agnes, we'll be leaving behind the community we've built. And for us to leave all those behind, that's the hardest thing that we will ever do. But there is nothing we can do. Perhaps this is what fate has in store for all of us. I will go and talk to Galleta. That maybe she would allow, in the event that I passed away. For my remains to be laid beside the grave of Rosario.
Sir Sebio, please don't worry. Even if Madame Galleta drives us away from here, we won't leave without a fight.
Oh, hello, ma'am? Yes, good morning, ma'am. This is Xander Grandis speaking. Ma'am, is it all right if I speak with your boss now? It's about the sponsorship we solicited. What? No, no, this is really Xander, ma'am. Oh. Hello? Hello?
No good.
She recognized my voice. Now you try it.
Hey, wait, wait! What will I say?
Just talk like to this? Her.
Hello? This is Xander. Could I please...
Bro, not like that. It won't work.
Just look for Xander.
Mon, get the door.
Oh, Xander!
At last! Bro, what happened to you? Why do you look like that?
Had they been torturing you? You look like you're starving. Come on, dude, eat first.
Bro, so how do you escape? You paid them? Good thing you managed to escape.
You really something, bro. How did you escape them? Where did they lock you up, bro? Maybe
instead
you...
of fuzzing over him, why don't you focus on the sponsors? Maybe you can call them. You're here anyway. Surely it won't be a bother to you.
Can I just eat first and take a shower?
That's no good. You just sell the parts. The engine's useless.
But how much do you think we'll get if we sell it part by part?
Around $200.
$200? That's still not enough. It won't cover our debt.
It's better than nothing, Boobs. It's still substantial.
But you'll have to pay $100 for towing services.
I'll still deduct $100?
No. It's no use. Start getting in touch with your relatives for a place to stay.
Let's go.
Agnes is now our only hope.
Madam Galleta?
Oh, Agnes, what brings you here? Do you have my money now? Is this $800?
It's not. It's only $400, but at least we only need to pay $400 more. Will that do for now, madam?
You better start packing.
Madam Galleta, I'm begging you, please don't send us away. Please give us another week or more, even several days maybe, for us to settle what we owe you.
Well, a promise is a promise. The $800 is to be given in a week's time. That's what we agreed on. So by sunrise tomorrow, I will be there. And if you still don't have the full amount that you all owe me, then I will definitely make certain that my property is vacated!
Madam Galleta! Here, Sir Sabio. Coffee.
Thank you.
There. Oh, boy, Agnes is here.
Come on, let me take care of that.
What did she say, dear? How was it?
She doesn't want a partial payment.
So, are you saying it means this is goodbye?
No, Sir Banky. The last day isn't over yet. We can still do something. We'll gather newspaper or old bottles or old books and we'll sell them. We can still make it to town. Let's go. We can still do this. Come on.
I think I still have some old newspapers that I can gather, including the old books of Nick Nock. Let's go, Nock.
We've got some old books and old clothes, I guess.
No, we're all out, I'm telling you.
No, we'll find something.
Let's go, Dad.
Okay. Dear, that's enough. Dear, that's enough.
No, Dad. We can still use these. We can still sell all of these things. And, Dad, I think we still have some clothes that we can still sell as well.
Dear, we may not have clothes left for us. Besides, we won't be accepted wherever we transfer if we're naked.
Dad, I'll risk being naked if it means not letting the people of La Presa down. When, what happens to Sir Spanky, Cesar, and Sir Sepio? Mrs. Rosario might haunt him if we leave. What if Mom returns? How will she find us?
We're both on Facebook, right?
There's more back there.
Dad, isn't this Xander? Alexander Grandi III?
His surname's not Diaz?
Dad, he's a grande. He's a grande. They're rich. There's still hope for us, Dad. Dad, don't be nervous, okay? We won't be doing anything wrong. We're just here to inquire. Excuse me, miss. Is Sir Alex Grande here today?
May I get your name, ma'am?
I'm Agnes Calay. This is my father, Buboy.
And why are you looking for him, ma'am?
We're hoping to talk to him about a personal matter regarding his son, Xander.
Ma'am, if it's a personal matter, I'm very sorry, but
can you at least give us his home address or maybe his telephone number?
Ma'am, if you want, I can give you the email address of my boss.
I'm sorry, miss, but we really need to talk to him right this minute.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but there's nothing I can do.
I think we should just wait for him. I'm sure he'll pass by soon.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Do I have other meetings today?
Let me check. Oh, so far, sir, you're done with all your meetings and appointments because the social media promotions has been moved for tomorrow.
Good. So am I free to go?
By all means, sir. Bye. Oh, I forgot. You see, Madam Soledad requested for you to be on standby in case the Montesillos would call for an emergency meeting.
Okay, I'll just be here checking my mail.
Okay, sir.
Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Don't worry, Agnes. He'll pass by here soon. Maybe he's in a meeting. You know how rich people are. They never tire of counting their money.
Excuse me, sir, ma'am. Loitering isn't allowed here.
Come on, Dad. Let's just wait outside.
Sorry, ma'am. Loitering isn't allowed outside either.
Sir! The Montesillos already called. The emergency meeting is pushing through with Madame Soledad and the Montesillos. They'll wait for you in the venue and the car is already waiting.
I have to go now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It was an order from our management,
Don't
sir.
Do this to us
we
just
have
because
VIP
we're
guests
poor.
Arriving.
We're not bad people, you know.
The management
you can't treat us this way just
orders.
Because we're poor.
Ma'am.
Wait, don't treat my daughter that way.
Hey,
we're
sorry,
not doing
sir.
Anything
I have
wrong.
To go.
Please, why are you doing this?
Let me call
Let's
him.
Go back inside,
sir.
Wrong. I'm sorry, sir.
You have to go.
Let me go.
Sir Alex! Sir Alex!
Wait.
Sir Alex!
Agnes!
Sir Alex, my name is Agnes Calay. Your son, Xander, owes us a lot of money. Sir, we need 300 bucks for the destroyed harvest and for the damage he caused us. I have it listed. Here.
I know my son, so I believe what you're telling me. But Miss Calay, it's Xander who owes you money. So he should be the one to pay you.
But he really doesn't want to pay us at all.
I'm sorry. I can't pay for my son's own debt. You see, if I do that, I will be tolerating his mistake.
Oh, please, Mr. Grande, our land and homes are at stake. That's the only thing that we have. I'm really begging you, sir. Maybe there's something else you can do. Maybe I can be a chambermaid here, or even a server. I'm willing to do anything, sir. We really need the money so badly, so I'm begging you, Sir Grande.
I'm sorry. I really can't pay the debt of Xander.
Agnes, let's go. We'll find some other way.
Agnes, wait. Sir!
I want my money back, Xander.
Wait, hold on, sir. I just arrived in Manila. I'll take care of this.
We had an agreement.
Sir, there's a reason why I was gone for a while. I got stuck in the mountains, looking for base jumping sites.
But I thought that was finalized.
Of course, but I wanted to find something better, sir. I want this big. Sir, I'm sure this will mean big returns for you.
Very well, but I want our event this week.
This week?
Bro, wait. Oh, cancel.
No,
cancel.
No, cancel.
Yes, sir. This week.
Oh.
Yes, sir. You got my word, sir. Okay, sir. Goodbye.
Darn it, you gave them another promise?
Say some more and I'll be gone.
one. I have nothing else to wear.
Chloe.
Agnes and Sir Boy hasn't returned yet. It's late. Will we make it in time?
Where could the two of them be?
Well, Nick Nock and I went out to search for more things at the house, but when we got back, they were already gone.
Yeah, this was supposed to be their idea. I think we're just wasting precious time here. How much would this cost? I better start packing now. Good luck with that.
Hey, wait.
Walking out again.
Agnes will surely never leave us hanging. If they're not here, I'm sure there's a good reason why.
Let's all hope that when Agnes and Wu-Wei return, they have some very good news for all of us.
That's for sure.
If there's none, then I will really miss this place.
Well, me too.
Xander, Xander, wake up!
Your brother's here.
Oh. No, no. It's your father. Your father's waiting downstairs.
So, what happened? I want to hear it from you.
I just wanted to have some fun. I base jumped like I always do. There was a gust of wind. I lost control, fell on top of their truck. That's what happened.
But why did you base jump there? Are you allowed to do that in populated areas? You're the first person I've seen who's gone parachuting in our area.
Just because no one's done it, it's illegal?
Was it really a jumping site? It wasn't. Yet you still did it. That makes it your fault. And what about the truck?
I had to take care of something here. They wouldn't let me leave, so I tried to escape.
By sending the truck off the cliff? That was your idea of escaping?
It wasn't a cliff, exactly.
It doesn't matter. You still destroyed their property.
But I was going to pay them. Though not at the moment, because I have no money.
I will lend you money. But you have to pay me back by working for them. You will work for Agnes's family until you have earned the exact amount that I'm going to lend you. Until you have paid what I have loaned you.
That's crazy.
No, that's just fair.
Fair? They detained me. Was that fair?
We wouldn't have done that if you had just paid us up front.
And if I don't want to?
I'll have you arrested. And you know I can do it.
Then have me arrested.
Done. Mr. Kalai? Agnes, I'm sorry. I won't be able to help you. I'm sorry.
Sir Alex, please wait a minute.
There's nothing much I can do.
That's it? That's all this is to you? You would rather go to jail instead of owning up to your mistake, knowing that so many lives will be affected and inconvenienced? Do you know how many families will lose their homes all because of what you have done? Do you know how many lives you'll be saving if only you would bother to pay us today? La Presa isn't just simply our land and our home. It's our life. Well, I'm sorry. Sorry if we've given you a hard time. Sorry for dragging your father into this. Sorry if we had caused a rift between the two of you. We can no longer think of any other way for us to pay our debt. Please, I'm begging you. Please help us. You're our only remaining hope, Xander. I'm begging you.
No, Agnes. Don't ever lower yourself to someone who's heartless.
Why isn't Xander with you? Where is he?
We've already talked.
He knows that what I'm about to do is only for his own good.
What? But how?
Bettina, just let me handle this, okay?
No, Alex. I am his mother. I need to know what's going to happen to my son.
And I'm his father. Bettina, you can be a mother to him whenever he is at home. But for now, I will handle this, so don't go looking for him.
You won't be able to sleep if you drink too much coffee. I'll just wake you up the minute they arrive.
I really want to wait for them.
You, Cesar. Where will you take your family?
Perhaps I'll bring them to Amanda's sibling in Tarlac. Until we've saved enough to go to Iloilo.
Can I come with you?
Well, let's see.
Banky, you can come with us.
Oh, no, it's okay. You might fall for me.
You're never funny. Run out of jokes. Unbelievable.
Boy, what happened? Where have you been?
We found Sander's father.
And?
They don't want to pay us.
So they are alike.
I'm sorry.
Perhaps the time has really come for us to leave this place.
Agnes, listen to me. Agnes. Listen, I haven't told you. There's nothing wrong in being brave. But you also have to be brave when you fail. Even when things are hard and painful, right? Right? Well, it's that time.
Agnes, sorry. Boy, sorry. Agnes. Please don't be too hard on yourself. All of us are responsible for our debt to Madame Galietta. So don't put the blame on yourself. That's enough.
Come on. Stop crying. We will fight till the end. We shall overcome. We're brave. You okay? Huh? Be brave!
Demolish! Destroy everything!
No one is leaving!
You see, Xander's father already provided for the money he owes us. And Xander is supposed to pay back his father by working in the fields of La Presa as a farmer just like us.
It's his first day tomorrow, right? It's time to start teaching that boy a lesson.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Can't I take a short break?
But no matter how hard we try, we can't force a person to do something he doesn't want to.
It feels good to relax. You stalking me?
I just wanted to make sure that you wouldn't go back inside
There's
your
tent. There's two creatures that keep chasing after someone. A dog, and B, someone who's head over heels and madly in love with you. Which one are you?